Hi guys, welcome to another episode of How To Tutorials by Levonotion Studios. This is Super Sam once again, and in this very episode, I'm going to show you how to translate your static work cycle in Blender. Let's get started. Okay, so quickly, I have this simple scene, and I had to light up the scene using the physical atmosphere add-on, PSA, and it's so it's so easy to use. You can see I have some of the assets here that you can just drag in and drop, and that's going to change the look of your environment. So simple and fast. If you're interested in getting this add-on, the link will be dropped in the description below. So back to the main purpose of this shot. I have this work cycle here, and I'm going to switch back to this mode so everything plays faster. You can see the cycle I have here. So my intention now is to make this move forward. Okay, so to do this, I need to bring up my rig, and I would like to quickly go to the post mode, and this is what you want. You want the roots. And the direction of the root is very important. In my case, my root is pointing in the Y direction. So I would have to quickly go into my graph editor and select the channel, which is the Y channel. Alt H to unhide everything just for you to see. So by default, you have all your channels visible. So for me, I'm interested in a Y location, and I don't want to erroneously tamper with any of these other channels. So I need to use Shift H to hide every other channel except the selected channel, which is Y location in my case. And I have two keyframes on that. So I'm just going to select everything by using A on the keyboard, and then the period key on the number lock to zoom in the selected keys. Now I have the selected keys here. So when I scroll, I can see that frame 4 is the frame where the forward foot is planted. And I want this control, the foot control, I want it in one position as my root control moves forward. Now, to achieve this, all I need to do here is make sure I select both keyframes on the Y location. Right click on that and then change the interpolation to linear. That's the first thing you want to do. Now the second thing you want to do is you want to change the extrapolation mode to linear. Now the difference between linear and constant is, for constant, every other frames without the keyframe would retain the keyframe information of the last frame that has keyframe. But when you have linear on, it's not going to retain that information. It's going to give you an incremental value for every other frame. So it's like the computer animating for you. So in this case, that is what I want. I just want to drop two keyframes, and I want the computer to do the rest in a linear fashion. Okay, so once I have that and I move my keyframe using the G, you can see I can move awkwardly using G alone, but I want to constrain my movement to just the Y axis. So I'm going to use G and Y, and that is going to constrain it. So currently I have both keyframes selected, so I'm just going to deselect and select one keyframe alone. So now I have my G, so G, Y. And as I push forward, I notice this zigzag kind of shape, and that is unwanted. This is not what my linear should give. The problem is I have cyclic on for this channel, so I need to just turn off cyclic. So clear cyclic. All right, because it was initially a work cycle, so you need F cyclic for the work cycle. Now I need to just turn it off for this particular route. So as I scrub, my character is going backwards, and this is not what I want. So if the character is going backward, I need to push the route forward. So select this GY to constrain and push forward. So let me stop here for now and scrub. still going backwards. I still need to go forward. GY, push forward, scrub. Now it's going forward. So I'm going to zoom in and push in backward. Now I'm going to scrub again. So the battle is between the root control and the planted foot control. So I'm looking at that red control and I'm looking at my selected root control as well. I don't want to see any movement here, any motion. Okay, there's still slight forward, I guess. Yeah, so I need to push him backward just slightly. Still need to push in. So I'm gonna scroll in, just zoom in, G, Y, and move ever so slightly. Ever so slightly. Okay. So yeah. That's all. So you can see when you scrub, this control remains in the same position. So I'm going to select it so you can see. It remains in the same position with respect to the moving root. Yeah, so that is how you have it. Okay. So now my character is moving forward without the foot slide. I know most people have challenge of getting their foot to stick. This is just how you can do that. I hope you've learned one or two things from this video. By the way, we have an add-on called a Translational Walk Aid that can help you out with things like this, and you don't have to stress yourself trying to make the roots move forward. But with the Translational Walk Aid, you can make your character walk forward, or you can make the character walk backward. You have the option to change your stride length. So the wider your character's feet is, it's going to give you that same stride length while the character walks, and you also have the option of defining the keyframe interval for it. So it's a very wonderful add-on. You can check that out on Blender Market, and the link would also be dropped in the description below. So guys, I hope you've learned one or two things from this video. This is where I'm going to call it a wrap. Until next time, keep your creativity blending.